Hey guys, Monday afternoon. It's chilly again around here. It's like 40, 45 and windy. It's cold. Not quite snow cold, but I heard it was sleeting a little bit in Norfolk today. Just a little bit in the morning. Anyway, this first video for today is going to be about a delivery from Canada. One of my best buds on YouTube, Ninja X Bart Spencer, as you also know him as. You know he is an artist. And I sent in a request for a picture. Paid and everything. I'm not trying to. There's some people you got to support, and that's people within your own community. I wasn't going to go beg for a free picture or anything. So I paid for a picture I'm going to show you in a minute. God damn it, stay up there. So first I got this ninja sticker, which is sweet. Now, I don't know if this is your personal ninja sticker, Spence, or if you just bought it, or if it's a known logo, or if you custom designed it, if this is just for your channel. I don't know. But man, shit, I'm running out of spots in my toolbox. I don't want to hide it. I mean, I want that kind of... I've been just avoiding, you know, stickering the lower section forever and ever, but it may be time to just do it and just kind of forfeit and go screw it. Maybe time to start spreading the sticker love. I thought about putting it on my car, but I just couldn't do it. You know, I like, it's so clean now with the rear. So I've christened my lower box with the first sticker ever. Now it's all over, stickers will go everywhere. Kind of once you do one, you're done. So I'm no longer gonna keep this, the messy box, and keep that cherry. Hell, I'm gonna have this box probably a long time. And I haven't even showed you the picture yet. Let me show you my rear real quick. Remember my debadge in the light? Now it's not that clean, but you can see. Now, a few days later, I found like where all the dust was sticking was more glue remnants. So I had to go back and, you know, alcohol, certain tiny little specks of glue which were attracting the dirt, and you could see lines. So just keep that in mind if you do that. You may think you got it all and come back later. Anyway, that's my bare ass. It's so shiny and beautiful. Dang. Especially with the dark tinted emblem there. So it's a real mystery, I guess, except to most people in the world that know what a Subaru looks like. But it just feels like a real mystery. Nothing on the front except the same tinted dark emblem hidden behind tint. So no more lower, remember that. I'm really liking it, real clean. All right, let's get to whatever the hell I'm talking about. Let's just get to the business. I'm trying to get a good light, damn it. I have to have, the light has to be behind me. That's sort of lighty, I guess. I know what I'll do. I'll put on this big lamp right here to shine light hopefully down on me right here. If I point the camera outside, the glare always makes it crappy. And here we have a Fuji Color Crystal Archive paper, 8x10. And I'm getting a frame for this. I'm not even gonna put a thumbtack through it. Are you crazy? Look at that. Number two of however hell many, I got no clue. I can't remember. I think I saw it on the site as some, maybe a limited edition. It just happens to be white. I think they're all white, but pretty cool that it's the same as my car. And even as the yellow fog lights in there, pretty freaking awesome. So that's gonna go in probably an 8x10 frame if that fits. He'll probably tell me on this video comments. Thanks a lot, I really like it, it's awesome. It's really perfect. And I can't wait to get that framed. And if someday I don't have a Subaru, this will be a strong memento of the Subaru life I once led. All right, thanks a lot, Spence. And I'm gonna put this back in its cardboard until I get a frame, because I don't want nothing to happen to it.